Good meowing. A meowing. Meowing. Hello. Hello. Early cat. Early cat. You could tell in my voice that I'm EP. Again. But this time for a goddamn reason, because I literally just woke up. Hello, gamers! Hello! Hi, Abyss! Thank you for the first welcome, me, cutie. Hi, Blood Panda! Welcome in! Welcome in! Hi, Shrimpy! Hello! Hello, hello! Hi! Ah! Owie! Why? Why you bonker? Why? Why? Why you bonker? Thank you for the raid last night. Of course! Of course! I'm happy to support friends. Happy, 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 happy! Oh no, it was totally fine. I'm totally fine raiding into someone who's quote-unquote not doing much. Any stream content is good content. Don't you worry about that. It was pre-alpha early access? I don't even know what the hell that even freaking means, bro. What? That was fun? What do you mean? The bean boy's so cute. It's a cute little bean boy. A cute little baby. I saw that it was follower subscriber only mode. You should tell Gwentu that she might get more followers if she takes that off. Oh shit, my keyboard isn't working. I can't say hi to Abyss. Ah, hold on. She might get more followers if she turns that off because a lot of people are, yeah, when I went to raid, it said it was follower or subscriber only mode. So when we raided, I was like, okay, well, that's the situation, but, like, I highly encourage you follow because Gwen seems super sweet and really nice and, she's Shrimp's friend, so, yeah, but, but yeah, so it's very discouraging when new people come into a stream and it says that and they can't like chat and engage before following. Some people just follow, which is fine. But yeah, some people like to like engage with the stream before following, so that might deter some people. But yeah. Yeah, let her know and see how she feels about it. She might want it on. Which is also fine, but it might bring more engagement if she turns it off. So just let her know that. Just let her know. Yeah. Yeah. Hi Fox. Hi, welcome in. Good morning. Good morning. Well, I guess happy time zone. What time is it for you guys right now? It's 7 AM for me. It's 7 AM. It's very early. I had to take my meds. They're here. I have to take my meds, but if it's on, means somebody was being creepy. And it's on purpose. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Totally, totally. Yeah, totally fair. Totally, totally fair. Totally understand that. We call that block and bye bye. Move on with our day. Maybe I'll ask her if. Nobody can friend me on Discord, but ask her if she's okay with me sending her a friend request in Discord, and then me and her can chat about some settings on Twitch. Because you can make it so once you ban someone, they literally can't even view your stream anymore. But once you ban them, they're like gone. They're gone, gone. So, I mean, the only reason you would ever really need follower only mode is if you're getting like hate rated or something. So that's okay. That's okay. Some people are new to shit. I've been doing this for 3.5 motherfucking years, so there's still stuff I probably don't know, but you know. But yeah. It's my favorite song, but it's too early to go, 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 go. Head so good, she on a roll. Speak like carnival. I did the impossible. Oh. Oh. Boss. Good morning, Fox. Good morning. I'm good. I'm good. We're waiting for my VTuber brother to do his debut. He's starting in 2 hours. Ah, I'm so excited. I'm so excited. You need a Sky Bop emote? I have so many like Cat Jam ones on 7TV. Stop spraying me! Stop! I didn't get to finish reading Fox's message. Are you chilling at work? About to go home? Yay! Yeah, work went well. You do night shifts, Fox? Work wasn't too bad. Yay! Take a bath, Nikki? I will after the stream. I went my rocket ship. It's time to go home. Don't make him drink the yarn. Really calls me bitch. Like a ventriloquist. Go, 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 go. Head so good, she on a roll. She ride the dick like a carnival. I done did the impossible. Go, 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 go. Head so good, she on a roll. She ride the dick like a carnival. I done did the impossible. Ah, someone do exclamation point song. My keyboard isn't working. Stupid ass keyboard, stupid, 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 stupid. Hey, no, Sue, hi. Hi. You good coffee bean, yippee. The dick like carnival. I done did the impossible. Go, 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 go. Head so good, she on a roll. She ride the dick like a carnival. I done did the impossible. Go, 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 go. Okay, I'm done. I'm done. Hi, Nax. Welcome in. Welcome in. I'm gonna fix my keyboard. One sec. I don't know which USB port it is down there. So I just do both of them. You probably heard two different window sounds. Bloop, bloop. Bloop, bloop. That song. There you go. There you go. There you go. There you go. This one has a sample of what's it called? The reason I like this song is because it has a sample of that old song. Fuck, what's it called? This song. What's it called? Enjoy the Silence. Enjoy the Silence by Depeche Mode. That's what it is. It samples that song. That's probably why it sounds familiar. I could request a really good song, but it has a scream so you would not like it. You can still request it. I might like it, you never know. All by myself. I'm doing good, Nax. How are you? How are you? It's nice to see you. How you doing? There's a Spotify suggestions channel in the Disky. Just pop it in there and then I'll check it out. What is happening to Mally's stream? Oh my god. Her last stream, she was at like 45 hours on her subathon. And I opened it just to look. She's over 100 hours. She's on day 30. She's been at it for a month. She's at 100 hours. Yeah. If you do this to me, I'm gonna be mad. I'm gonna be really thankful, but I'm gonna be mad. Cause I can only take off a week of work. Okay? You gonna make me stream every single day after work for a month? Please. Don't do this to me, okay? You've been playing Destiny 2? Nice! Wasn't there an update recently? My friend Arthur plays a lot of Destiny 2. Look at this shit. She's where we were yesterday in Elden Ring. Hello? Oh. It's not capturing because... It's not Firefox. Makes sense. Look at this shit. The fuck? Jake went crazy. What did 900 gifted subs! Wasn't he at like 300 or 400 or something? What the fuck? Yep, he went crazy. He went crazy. Wow. That's unfortunate for Mally. Hold on. Click, click, click. Banning Jake. I so desperately want to ban Zanzu as well. Oh, look, Zanzu gets it another 111 subs. Look at that. Very nice. Very nice. Wow. Mally stopped having goals like 1,000 subs ago. What the fuck? I need my nut, bro. Wow, she killed him right away.
Hello, Sky! Welcome here!
Just here to nut. I'm also streaming. You are hot. I love you.
Are you excited for the debut, Sky? Are you excited for the Zandy debut? Said to Nana, I was streaming. You are hot. I love you. Okay, Sky. Wait, I need to lurk. Hold up.
No. Mally, no. No. She's gonna see her that I'm on her stream. Up.
I saw myself on the stream. What are you doing, Sky?
Nothing!
I gotta work on my sign.
Nothing.
Lurk, thank you for the lurky. The Discord. Yes. God damn it.
Nothing.
Welcome in. Welcome.
Funny. It's funny.
I'm climbing something. Sorry, I'm so goddamn all over the place, chat. I'm not settled whatsoever. Jesus Christ. What do we have here? A giant prayer book.
What? I didn't get that. Right. I need to go get that.
Thing is that a... Oh, I thought it was a frozen possum for a second. That is not a fucking possum.
We didn't finish this place, did we? Oh, no. We just killed that guy and then...
I'm kidding. Thank you, I guess.
Ended stream, right?
Thank you. What about this shit? Maybe there's something secret if I do this? No? Nothing?
Whoops, don't perceive that.
Hello, motherfucker.
Hello, motherfucker. Ba da ba da ba da ba. No, don't look. Don't look. Okay, I missed some chat. I'm sorry. New DLC came out? Yeah. It's 100 pounds! What? Hold on. 100 pounds in Canadian? That's like almost $200. Who in the right mind? Oh, euros. I think that's close to the same. $150. Who in their right mind makes DLC that expensive? What the hell? My last team lead was a Destiny 2 fan, and she was always like, I am so angry when we talked about the game. Yeah, I ain't paying that much for the DLC. No kidding, you're not paying that much. That's ridiculous. We were supposed to put out new ones today. Oh, new goals, really? We requested 2 songs. First one is the one I don't think you'll like, but the second one I think you would. Okay, sounds good, Shrimp. Mally has base sword. Yeah, she has a pretty cool sword. She's been switching up her weapon pretty often, which I think is cool. Hi, Abyss. Hi. Hi, Final. Welcome in. One of you. Sky ruins friendship by being too supportive in the wrong way. Oh. Stalker behavior. Right! Is it 100 pounds and I thought you meant weight? So you were converting? I was like, Canadian have their own pounds. Dude, there's pounds, there's kilos. What else is there? Oh yeah, Canadian. Guys, I got my yam fries yesterday, but I was too hungry. I didn't take a picture. I ate them all so fast. And judges, thank you for the follow. Welcome in. Bungie is the one who makes their DLCs hella expensive. Bruh. That's crazy. Hello, kitty. You're at your sleepovers right now? Oh my god, don't be here, Irene. Go enjoy your friend time. Not the yams. Yes, the yams. I mean the sweet potatoes. Mm. You've seen the GDC with the creative director at Bungie? It makes sense. Oh. I don't know what that means. I'm hungry, chat. I did have a good time. We weren't there for very long. I don't know how it went by so fast, but it was good. It was good. They didn't let me sleep last night? Bah, no sleep? What? I'm with them right now? Oh my gosh. Tell them the stinky moon cat says... Moon's cat says they're stinky. They're stinky. Hey, why, Abyss? Why? One of the higher ups at Bungie did a game dev conference, and his presentation was how you milk your player base effectively. Ew, I hate that. Oh. There's so many series that like do that though, like The Sims 4. Ugh. Have you seen the price of every single pack they release? Ugh. Barf. Freaking what else is there? I don't know. There's other stuff, but many words over 2 hours. That's what it boiled down to. Damn. Hi Fiesta. Hi, welcome in. How are you doing? Good morning. And meowing. Some funk. I can't get too hype. It's too early. We had an hour for the escape room yesterday. We escaped with 54 seconds remaining. Let's go. You did so good.
Hello, motherfucker.
Igor. Hi, Igor. Hi, kitty. Hello. Thank you for the follow. More rating rooms. Let's go. Yeah, I got up early for this. It's 7:30 a.m. Shira. I'm AP Cat. AP Cat. He's an AP. Had a tornado at my house last night. I saw that in the Discord, Fiesta. Are you okay? Hi, Uncle. Hello. Some standout quotes I remember was him saying how you should de-emphasize a stable launch in favor of a strong roadmap. Bah. And that the order of operations is player trust, player retention, and then profit. I'm flabbergasted. I'm gobsmacked. Hi, Flower. Hi, cutie. Welcome in. Thank you for lint and the sticky note. I did one pile of the sticky notes on the new model yesterday. I did the insults. And I need to do the other two piles, the compliments. Or the three other piles, the compliments, the emotions, and then all the others. Random one. We get the gamers. I did a lot of redeems. I did like the, you know how the redeems have pictures? So I took screenshots of the model with the different hairstyles and outfits for the little pictures on the redeems and stuff like that. And put all those in. And use some emotes for other redeems, like, I'm not gonna say. Like head pat. I can say that. So I use my head pat emote, on the new head pat redeem. Make that look all cute. And yeah. I did a lot of work night after I got home from dinner. I'm cooking, chat. Let her cook. I still have so much to do. But we getting there. I was lucky enough that the tornado roped out before it hit the neighborhood. Oh, thank goodness. That rotation 100% went over my house. That's so scary, Fiesta. Oh, I'm glad you're okay. So many people had a tornado warning yesterday. Excuse me. Oh, shit. I have to take my meds. Makes sense to, that we now have $200 DLCs. That's freaking bogus, dude. That's crazy. Ain't no motherfucking way. That's like as much as a fucking console. What the hell? You love this song? Oh, I love that we're like the same age. Theoretically, based on our knowledge of things. Like TV shows, music, and stuff like that. Commercials. Every time I say something, I'm like, does anybody remember? And Flower's like, I do. And I'm like, God bless you, Flower. They keep talking a lot and it's really loud. Sounds like it's time to go home, Irene. Sounds like it's time for home time. I gotta take my smaller little meds real quick. Oh my god, Mally has a Trinket Pedro emote? Ain't no way. Mac! Hello, Mac! Welcome in! How are you? Good meowning. Good meowning. Good meowning. Hello, how are you? Good morning. Hello, hello. Orc Slayer, wow, everybody's here this morning. Wow. That's good. I want to give Zindi a big raid. What the gamers doing? We chillin'. Where my future VTuber brother is debuting in about an hour and a half. We're just building a waiting room and then we're gonna raid him when he starts stream. I'm very excited. Have the songs I recommended ever played yet? I don't think so, but I did listen to one of them. I can't remember which one it was. But I did enjoy it. And it get me adding to you. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. What DLC were we talking about? Oh, Destiny 2. The Destiny 2 DLC. Allegedly very expensive. 99 euros. 144, I think it said, Canadian. So that means, like, what, 120 American? Crazy. All aboard the Ray Train. Yeah, isn't that bonkers? Isn't that crazy? So expensive. And for what? It's downloadable content. What the frick? What the frick? I guess so. The newest one, I believe. What the frick? I like when you type out what I say. Like, so literally. Omo! Hello, Omo! Welcome in! Hi! It's such a cute little emote. Oh, this is so funny, Mac. Yabba, jabba, jabba. We're having two streams today, by the way. After I end this stream, I'm gonna hang out in Zindi's stream. Probably do some more work on the new model, and then we're doing a regular stream at 2 p.m. PST. Should do some more Elden Ring base game. No DLC yet. Get this work. Now get this work. You looking for cars? You looking for a new car, Omo? No way. Only 60 Canadian here? Really? I just looked up the conversion. Destiny 2 DLC. The final ship. DLC page on Steam. Guys, I unironically love Iggy Azalea. Don't hate me, okay? Now I'm in this bitch. Yeah, it says $124.99 Canadian. Oh, it's the annual pass. Plus annual pass. Oh, maybe that's what we're looking at. But there's no other option. Oh, okay. So just the final pass is 6249. Just the final shape is 6249, and the final shape plus annual pass is 124.99. I see. I see. The annual pass is what frickin' hikes up the price. What the fuck is annual pass even fucking mean? Stupid. Sounds good, Irene. Sounds good. Zanzo. Hi, Zanzo. I see you did some damage in Mally's subathon. I see you did some Look at the spinning lint on my head! Oh my god. That was so cute. Well, the perfect meme idea. I need to act on it when I'm done making breakfast. Okay, we're doing meme review on Wednesday. I forgot to put it in the picture in the schedule in the Discord. But I added it in the text, so. Added it in the text. Did I miss anything in chat? Yes, enjoy your times with your friends, Irene. Enjoy your time with your friends. Yo, that lint is twerking. Get it, lint? A car that works, fair, Omo, fair. And now Sheepy's freaking twerking on my head. Damn. Get those twerks. Those twerks. Remember when they deleted all the previous Destiny 2 DLC so you couldn't play it anymore? No, I don't remember that, but that sounds terrible. I don't ever want to play Destiny ever now. I did nothing. I'm sorry, but you had 1,000 gifted subs and now you have 1,111. So I see it right there. I see it right there. You didn't do as much as Jake, but you did something. You did something. Hi, Spence! Welcome in! Welcome in. They see me rolling. They hating. Don't you ooh-woo. Don't you ooh-woo. Oh, they did. I love that. Destiny D's nuts. That's what I'm saying. Fuck that game. That's illegal in some Euro countries? No way. Ah! Meow! Meow! No! Zanza! No! No! Mm-mm. Mm-mm. Put your wallet back in your ass. Put it back in your ass. Why are you spraying me? I didn't do anything! What tax? There's no tax here! There's literally no tax! What tax are you speaking of? Oh my god. Thank you for the 10 gifted. What the fuck? What the fuck? Toucan? Oh, Rarity! Rarity's here. I just saw Rarity. And to Cass? Chef Cass? And to Nosu? Nosu was just here? Yay! Thank you, Sansu! He's huge. Sansu, thank you. Is that where you're supposed to keep it? Yeah, it is. It is. Getting called out tax? Hey, yo. Do I have to pay tax? No, Omo, no, there's no tax. There's no tax. There is no tax. Waifu, good morning. Good morning. Okay, all right. All right. All right, I've had enough. I've had enough. Pay the stream toll? There's no stream toll.
Zanso as well.
See? Did you hear that? Mally literally just said your name.
Animal. Opa, Rochelle! Thank you for the tier 1, 3 months! Thank you so much! I almost said tier 3, 1 month. I almost swapped the numbers. Thank you so much! I really appreciate it! Topo, I was ending waiting room. Wahoo! Waha! I am so excited. I'm so excited. I'm so excited. I'm so excited. Woo! Hey, hello, Snowy! Welcome in! Verde! Thank you for the gift of the angel! Calm down, Jesus Christ! Thank you for the gift of the angel! Verde, thank you!
Zandy, shut up!
I just said I missed the crazy train. It was the VODs are up. He's crying like a bald egg. Me crying as a bald egg.
What do you think the IRS adds for internal revenue?
I don't know how you have 50 gifts and not a sub yourself. It happens. It happens.
Oh my god.
It happens.
Oh my god.
It happens. Thank you so much for that.
That's so funny. Aye, aye.
Let's save it for Zindi debut.
Yeah.
Let's save it for Zindi. I have more than enough hours on my clock today, Chan. I have more than enough hours on my clock.
Zindi's doing a...
Let's save it for the Zindi subathon.
Subathon too, right?
Let's save it for the Zindi subathon. Anyways, I hope gameplay...
Yeah, 100 hours on the clock on day 30.
That's okay, thank you so much for coming by, Angel. Thank you. Thank you, thank you.
Bonkers.
I was just filling a blank spot. Feeling a blank. Actually, can we have a shout out for Zindi? In case people needs to leave and then wants to come back and then they don't know where they are. That's a good idea. We're gonna be at Zindros' channel. Do we have any mods in here? Mod check. Hi, Winter Nick! I didn't see you! Welcome in! How are you doing? I'm good! How are you? I'm sorry.
Do relax. We have a mod in relax, gamer. You're already number one, okay? Suffering. Relax. Nobody's gonna beat you.
I subathon when? I appreciate it. Yeah, the potential to be.
Nobody tell him. Nobody tell him. Nobody tell him.
I don't think I'll get there.
Bye, shrimp. One enjoy your breakfast. Bye.
One subby wubby.
Sounds good.
My brain don't work. That's okay. I'll do the shout outs.
Have a good breakfast now.
Let me see.
Good Bucky. I don't think she saw my message, but it's okay.
Zindruz. There you go. Easy shout out for the Zindi. If you want to, you can go follow him. Cool, he's the one we're gonna be raiding in 1 hour and 15 minutes.
No, not spent.
God, I'm so excited. I remember the first time with it.
No.
Zindi first debuted with his first model. I think I read it in with like 20 people. I think I read it to him with 20 people after the waiting room. And it was so exciting, and everyone was so excited. And a debut.
The cheese tax! The cheese tax!
No, there's
you gotta pay the cheese tax every time you're cooking. When the cheese comes out, this puppy comes looking. The rules are the rules, and the facts are the facts. And when the cheese
drawer
opens, you gotta pay the tax.
Do not forget that I'm the biggest mod. Do not forget that I am the biggest mod right now. If you misbehave, I will time you out.
Get out of here!
I will dime you out.
Get out of here, stinky. Shouldn't you be preparing for your debut, you stinky? What are you doing in here? Did you see everybody shouting you out in your activity?
Let's go fuck some bitches, yes.
Is that what happened? Okay, Mally, be quiet, Mally. Be quiet. Are you nervous? You're gonna do so good. You're gonna do so good, baby. You so eepy, waifu? It's okay. It's okay, me too. It's early. It's early for us West Coast gamers. You know, Zin! It's gonna be okay! You got this. We all believe in you! Well, that leg. We all believe in you. We're all gonna be there for you. You can do it! I'm literally so excited. Yeah. We're all gonna be there to support you. Yeah, save the shaking and crying for the stream. Free content. The starlings will be there. The trinkets will be there. What does Shira call her community? What does Shira call her community? Fuck, I don't know. Everyone's gonna be there. Everyone's gonna be there. Your community's gonna be there. Everyone. You didn't go to sleep till 4 a.m.? Why? Couldn't sleep? Sounds good, gamer. You got this! You got this! Why am I lagging? Because Firefox is open? That's bogus. All I gotta do. Google Chrome takes way less CPU. It's strange. And take your money. Bow, bow, bow. Bow, 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 bow. And take your money. I feel bad when I listen to this song in the car, because sometimes I do like the little gun motions. Like in the car driving and I'm like, bow, 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 bow. I'm like, I shouldn't do that. What if they think I'm a terrorist? You were on Elden Ring all night? Oh, waifu. You need to prioritize your health. You're rolling on 5 hours of sleep as well? Oh, no. I think I got about 5 as well, but that's normal for me. It's okay, Sky won't hit anything. Yeah, I never hit anything. Never. Except for mediums. I'd be hitting those. That might be called delirium, Omo. That might be called overtired. 4 to 3 hours of sleep? Yeah. Yeah. I need to buy more NyQuil because I rely on that shit to fall asleep. And stay asleep. I just take, like, a little of NyQuil every night. Four to 5 hours is pretty normal, yeah. What do you mean, what? I would never hit you, Spence. Yeah, I take NyQuil. I have intense anxiety and my brain does not shut the fuck up unless I take something. And I cannot take... Oh, there's a Z-Quil? Melatonin gives me fucking nightmares. And I also wake up really groggy. Wait, there's Z-Quil? Well, I also have this thing where when I lay down, I cough a lot. Or to eat? I was also thinking of getting that gamer subs sleepy. The EP gamer subs. You have nightmares regardless, waifu. I'll see if we have the Z-Quil and try that. Maybe my coughing's gone away. I don't know. Because I have an anxiety pill that helps me sleep, but I must do as doctor and therapist recommend and not take that every night. It's not a daily medication. So I do not hit Spence. So I Just take NyQuil instead. It's literally a vitamin. I think you just have nightmares. No, melatonin nightmares are a thing. Like, I've never had such motherfucking intense nightmares as I did when I was taking melatonin every night. With love and Lucky. With modded love. I'm mwah. Is my, I wonder if my thing is updated. I don't remember the last time I did it. It is updated! Look at that! Blink once if you need help, blink twice if you're okay. Spets can't blink. I've sewed his eyes open. He can watch the stream eternally. No, I'm kidding. That's some fucking Coraline shit. Oh my god. Did you guys hear that Coraline's coming back in 3D? There's so many scenes in that movie that would be so cool in 3D. Bruh. I wanna see it. I wanna see it! No, I don't wanna be in my Jigsaw era. No. But they get free leather. Oh my god. Not the Ski Holmes. The Ski Holmes syndrome. I think my whole chat got the Ski Home syndrome. Bruh. Oh my god. Mech was mod once, I know. True. Oh my god. Mech and Hilt and Pup are a different breed of mod. They're not real mods. They're just like I don't know what adjective to use. This is I was just thinking of that. I gotta be quiet. I'm crying. Don't talk about that. Oh my god. Oh my god. My stomach hurts. Oh my god. They're to blonk to blonk when need be. Yeah. They were just made mod once for like a particular reason, and then I just never took it away. I could take it away, but Pop. Why can't I speak? Wario, dancing Wario's in my brain turned into mush. Pup is a funny mod because Pup and Spence shout each other out and neither of them stream, so, and I think that's funny. And then Hilt always comes in and like shouts everybody out, which I think is funny. Dancing Wario is internal. Oh, I love it. Streamer has spies lurking in chat, disguises via Pew with their mods? Nah. Wario's, I should say. Yeah, there's multiple Wario's. It's true. I also want Spence made the Zelda CDI good happen, and now Spence needs to make the Wario's dancing happen because I've wanted that for a really long time too. Oh my god. Oh, so good, man. So good. So fucking good. It's the best. Good! I love it so much. Wario dancing? You haven't seen it, Spence? Oh my god. I must have the video saved, I'm pretty sure. Let me see. Miscellaneous? Other videos? Oh, I do. Look at this. It's gonna be probably really loud.
If I back it up, is it bad enough? When I throw it back, is it fast enough? If I speed it up, can you handle that? You ain't ready for this.
Now watch me throw it back. Okay, so this is the TikTok that fucking cracks me up every single motherfucking time I see it. So this is because this is the song that plays. That's why Mac was like, "Is this the Wario's dancing song?" It sure is. Watch me throw it back, throw it back. Bad in it. I can't, bro. Okay. I'm flirting bruh. Oh my god. Freaking classic. Holy shit. I love that. That video so much. Oh my god. Oh my god. Wario is one of my favorites. And Wario has such good side games. Like, if you didn't know, like, there's Wario games that are, like, legitimately so good. I can't remember what they're called, but I remember watching the Beard Bros play one. Yeah, it's like Wario just like getting cash money, and like, they're like legit like good games. I'm like, yeah, brother, fucking get it, my man. Wario on my WhatsApp. Wario on my Snapchat. Send me that booty in the mirror pic, please. I'm begging. Yeah, you're on that capitalism grind. And you know what? Who can blame him? Who can blame him? I still have what we're meant to take. I'm gonna take it real quick. Sorry, that one's hard to take. It's bigger. Instead of chasing princesses, Wario chases a bag. And as he should. As he should. horse pill. Come here. No, you're gonna spray me again. I don't wanna. Don't spray me. I'm staying over here. Stinky. Way that you're moving your body, come with me. Way that you're moving your body. Damn it. So mean. You come here. Okay, waifu, what is it? Hi, waifu. Hi. Mwah. That's what you get for abusing me all the time. You stinky. You stinky. Stinky. Abuse the cat. You get the smack. That's it, that's all. Aw, see, now you've made waifu upset. Abyss. You've upset waifu. You've upset waifu. Oh my god. Oh my frickin' god. Look what you've done. Good. Good. I don't want to follow this person anymore. So I'm going to unfollow. That's how it works, chat. It's literally that easy. Can you believe it? I didn't do anything wrong. I just don't feel like following them anymore. Who's searching for redemption? No. I'm not blocking. There's no blocking necessary. Oh yeah, people are going to TwitchCon soon. The Nordstrom one? Unsubscribe? I wasn't subscribed. No way! If I back it up, is it fast enough? When I throw it back, is it fast enough? Yes. Spence, can I buy you an Amazon gift card? Can I give you a gift? Can I do something for you? can I do something for you? Oh my god, you're making all my streaming dreams come true. Oh, I'm so happy. I'm so happy. Best one ever. Oh my god. Oh my god. I want to. What do you want? Oh my gosh. I only follow people that are friends. Friends are friends. I'm gonna have to clean out my follow list. Yeah, I do that every once in a while. Hi, Rarity. Welcome back. Welcome back. Forever, let's go. Pow. Let's go. Da dee da dee da. Dee da dee da. Da dee da dee da. Wow, Linty. Yeah. Most of my falls are from raids? Yeah. I was watching Ravi last night when I was doing all my streamer stuff. God damn it. And she was fighting Melania. People really thought she was gonna get it in 25 tries. I was like, did you watch her fight Gods Can Do? Ain't no freaking way. Sorry, not sorry, sorry. Ba-da-ba-da-ba. I'm so nervous that I'm gonna let one of my redeems freaking leave them on and then you guys are gonna see it. But so far, so good. So far, so good. Oh, my tummy growls. Let us see? No! No more spoilers! Guys, it's already, like, July. There's only 2 more months left. Only 2 more months. It's gonna fly by, dude. Fly by. There's no- I literally just looked. There's nothing there. So close to the Discord roll. Let's go! Let's go! We for gore by tomorrow? No, you won't. You'll talk about it every single stream. Also, I don't know if I told you, Mimi's new emotes, we have the same emote artist. My new emotes are the same artist, and we didn't even do that on purpose. Like, I was talking to the emote artist, and I was like, okay, yeah, I want to go through with the commission, blah, 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 and then she put me on the waiting list. And I was like, okay, perfect, thank you so much. And then I went and looked at the waiting list, and I saw Mimi's name there. And I was like, what the fuck? And I messaged her right away, and I was like, Mimi, what the fuck? It's very cute, right? It's very, very cute. The emotes are adorable. They're adorable. And I might also not before the debut, but I might also get her to upgrade the smag, upgrade the panels as well, and do like little shibbies around the panels, because I think that would be cute. But we'll see. Yeah, because her little shibby art is so cute. I love the one she did for Mimi. Yeah. You'll get your smug, don't worry. Na, na, na. Yeah, something like that. It's something like that. It's just funny that, like, we didn't even plan that. It just happened. And I was like, we're literally soulmates. love this for us. I love this for us. Ba-da-ba. Brain cell mates, yeah. And when I was putting the sticky notes on the new model, because there's so many layers to the hair and so many like layers to the bangs and stuff, the sticky notes, like, they stick weird. They look a little weird, but like they don't look weird, but they move. Like, even though I'm sticking them, so hold on, let me give an example. This is just the first one, so we're gonna use it. So like, when I stick this one on, oh no, it does the same thing. It does the same thing. Never mind. Never mind. I'm full of it. Because usually when you stick an item, if you grab a certain part of, like, I'm just explaining how VTube Studio works. When you grab a certain part of the object, that's where it pins on the model. So like, say if you, I know you can't see my mouse, but say if you grab like the middle of the sticky note and you're moving it, right? And then you let go, it's pinning the object in the middle of the sticky note. But if you grab it by like the tape, it's gonna pin it by the tape. So that's how it's gonna move, right? But because of how the hair moves, it's a little weird. But it moves the same way on the other model. It's just a little bit more fluid because there's a lot of layers and stuff. I'm full of it. It moves basically the same way. How many hairstyles we got? One, two. One, two, three, four, five. Five. Yep, five. I went ham on the hairstyles. I like having lots of different hair. Five hair, two outfits. Five hair, two outfits. One, two, three, four, five, six. Six toggles. Six emotions. One, two, three, four other toggles. Three chromas. That's it. Whoops. I didn't mean to do that. Sorry, chat. There we go. A lot. Did you want the... I think I asked you this before, but did you want the commission with the, like, the hairstyle of this model or the new model? Okay. Well, I guess you can pick a hairstyle once you see them all. Oh yeah, and I'm getting a reference sheet. I forgot about the reference sheet. Yippee! Yeah. And the starting soon screen is gonna be done soon. Emotes are getting animated. Almost done everything. Yay! I think your favorite is the braids? Ah. Interesting. Braids are cute. Yours is the short? Ah, okay. Okay. I see. I will say, basically what we have now, We have basically the same hairstyles. I didn't want to give anything up. So we have basically the same hairstyles as we do now. But they're all a little bit different. They're all a little bit different. So, you'll see. I had to change it up a little bit, you know? Short press librarian. Mm-hmm. That's Lays. That's Lays. That's Lays. That's the final form combo. I used to have long hair until I got sick of the heat. That's why I want to cut my hair. I'm so freaking hot all the time. Oh, damn, I'm sick of it. Hi, Shrib. Gwen said you're fine to DM her. Okay, I'll add her as a friend right now before I forget. Oh, her profile on Discord is really cool. It's all movie and schmovie. I love it. Okay, bye, 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 bye. Mwah, mwah, mwah. Cut it. I'm gonna get Sophia to do it at work. I asked her if she wanted to, cause she's been bugging the boys that she wants to cut their hair. And I was like, do you want to cut somebody's hair? You can cut mine. But ended up leaving early on Friday, so who knows? I think I have some frozen waffles. I might have that for breakfast. I'm gonna have to go get them quickly because I don't want to miss Cindy's debut. This guy comes back with frosted tips. Ain't no motherfucking way. I ain't Guy Fieri. No bully. No bully me, Abyss. I think I just either dyeing it or cutting it short again. Shoulder length. To help with the heat in the summer. Cause I'm sick of it. I never felt so low. Ocean eyes. We got like half an hour left. We want to watch something? Mm-hmm. Oh, I need to unfollow some people on the YouTubes. With their spoilery thumbnails, play Elden Ring. Ah. That looks better. I mean, thankfully that thing was in the trailer, but who knows what else they're gonna put up there. You, bye-bye. No frosted tips. No. No. Don't shout me out in my own chat! Jesus. Here, we can watch this. Ocean eyes. Ocean eyes. No fair. We watch Vidya for last half hour.
Hey there, it's Josh. Welcome back to Let's Game It Out. We're playing Blockbuster Inc. today, where we get to make and manage our own movie studio. I believe we can even film some stuff ourselves. So what are we waiting for? New game! First things first, we need to name our studio. And you can just randomly have it make your own thing for you. But why
clearly
do that
not
when we can just come up with our own? Such as unwatchable garbage. Yeah! And we can choose what decade we want to start in. And we're going to start as close to the modern era as we can. And down here we have some chosen starting genres and themes. I'm just gonna leave it on the defaults it gave me, which is the action and romance genres, and the themes are vampires in medieval times. Truly the most innovative.
Makes sense.
Ah, and here we are in our beautiful studio lot. Oh good, and our sign is here and everything. Soon everyone's gonna remember our movies. Or not, who cares? Anyway, whatever, it's time to build our studio. After all, these movies aren't gonna make themselves. And for that, we need to build some stuff. And thank goodness for this Sims-like familiar layout. Not even lying when I say this, I want something that's as easy as possible to understand. And we could go ahead and make these pre-made rooms, because we're gonna need all this stuff like a producer's office and a writer's office, and then these two that are both grayed out, which are probably audio and art direction. But I guess the game is telling us we don't need those to have a successful movie. And honestly, it just keeps going. And again, we're not gonna use the pre-made ones, because in my opinion, they're just way too small. But instead of doing that, let's just make one giant room. Yep, just like that. And
yep,
I wonder
perfect
if inside this one room, we can just nest in another room.
Yep,
it looks like we can. And then in that room, we're gonna place another room.
Yeah.
And another.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, looking good. And another really tiny room.
Perfect.
Right there in the middle. Okay, our studio is off to a magnificent start.
Beautiful.
Basically, we're gonna make each one of these rooms something. Although, first, we're gonna have to put some doors on these. Although, maybe not that one. It just doesn't have the pizzazz we're looking for. Ooh, how about something like this? More glass on your door means you should be careful of the paparazzi. I mean, being able to see through the door is better. Which means let's go ahead and do this one at the end, because look at this. All see-through all the time. That's definitely more of what we're looking for. Especially for what we're gonna make this outer ring of a room, which is to say we're gonna decorate it for the bathroom. So let's see. Let's take our one little bathroom stall.
Oh my god.
Put it as close to this door as we can. Yep, just like that. Everyone will get to view you coming out of that bathroom. Even the cars can get in on the action. And from adding that one thing when I mouse over that room, a little toilet pops up. Now it knows what it is, kind of. And if I move one level deeper, it goes away to show that this room is not yet assigned, and so on and so forth, which means I'm sure everything is working as intended. Anyway, back to the toilets. And honestly, let's try to make this bathroom setup as awkward as possible. Let's just use these stalls to make like a hallway. A hallway that's gonna help guide people to the next room. Yes, so far so good. Tons of toilets, really tight corridors. I'm sure there's people out there that hate this, but I bet there's also someone out there that loves this. I know I do. And there we go. Okay, I think we we've done it. We've gone ahead and filled up this entire space with a maze of toilets. So you enter the building through here, follow this narrow pathway against the wall all the way to the adjacent wall, and then you just zigzag back and forth, and so on and so forth. And then it takes you all the way around to this spot right here, which is where we're placing the door. Oh, and right next to it, the only sink in the entire bathroom. And now that we've put down the most important room, let's start on the next thing, which I think is going to have to be the canteen, which it looks like the two things we need in here is a kitchen and a kitchen table. So we're going to take our one kitchen and put it as close to the door as we can. And for our glorious seating, we're going to put that right about here. There we go. We're only going to put the one table down. Talk about an effective use of the space. Oh, and we're also going to give this room some exciting wallpaper. Ah, yes, like these candy canes. Finally, something we can all enjoy
all year round, whether
we want to or not. Oh, and we can't forget about adding a nice, clean floor tile. What a feast for the eyes. And moving on to the next room, which, let's see, what do we think?
Producer
office? Why there's no wallpaper in the bathroom, though?
Not
yet. Ah, yes, there we go. Maintenance. We want these workers to feel well taken care of, and that's why we're going to give them extra decorations. Oh, what the hey, why not a whole bunch of couches? And lastly, we have to give them some lockers. Otherwise, the game isn't going to know that this is a maintenance room. Okay, and moving on. This next room, as we get closer to the center, that's where we're going to put our writers. Wow, look how needy they are. They need four different things. Why do you need a writing desk? I thought that's what Starbucks was for. Whatever, we'll just put it right there. And they're going to need whiteboards, so we'll go ahead and put those on the opposite side. Hopefully, that makes them less useful. And lastly, some cabinets. Here's your small one, and also your big one. Intentionally facing out this way, the opposite of where the writer's desk is, so that if this writer needs to access them, they have to walk all the way around.
Oh, and finally,
we come to the producer's room, where some of the game's visual stuff is still waiting for them, like an ion cannon trying to hit them from space. Let's go ahead and put them under the weird beam thing. There we go. Perfect. You and your suitcase full of money will be very happy here. And then way in the back is where we're going to put the rest of the stuff. Oh, and also nobody gets windows. You guys have to earn those with good movies. Oh, except the bathroom level. You guys get some windows. Because in the bathroom, it's always showtime. And now that our amazing studio is ready for prime time, we're going to need to hire some people to run it. So let's get started.
Goody.
We've got stuff like actor, as well as director, as well as producer. Actually, you can just look at this list. That's all the things we have. And they all have like different talents and stuff. Like this sloth icon means that they're a slacker. Produces worse results at work. Well, that's the kind of go-getter attitude we're looking for.
Oh, you're hired.
Look at her. She already looks resentful to have a job. I mean, there's good traits too. Like someone could be laid back, which affects their happiness. But really what I'm looking for is only red. Like Raymond here, I think is going to be a great writer because he's a slow learner. And for Heath, this actor over here, you would think he'd be a great catch. You know, with the thing about being easily stressed and less happiness. But then I saw this big shiny gold icon. A-lister? And this person's a B-lister. Oh, see, here's what I'm looking for. A nobody. Looks like you're also hired. I'm sure you'll be an amazing producer.
A nobody.
If we don't like our options here, I believe we have to wait until the next refresh, which is going to happen in March 2010. And right now, it's only January 2010. That's okay. We have another option. It's called the character creator. And oh my goodness, look at this. We can create any kind of character we want. We can dress them up in any era of outfit we want. We can go for that more modern look, or less modern, or just straight vintage. But thank goodness they have so many styles of glasses already. The only factor that matters, different sweet shades. And I appreciate that there's sliders that we can use to establish how old or young they are. And we can choose their profession, but also we get to decide their skills? Like, I mean, why wouldn't you take their charisma and move it all the way to the top, as well as their athleticism, and just make them the perfect specimen? And we could also make their fame super high to be a superstar, and choose nothing but positive traits. All that matters is they're perfect. For someone else, I mean. We won't be doing any of that. If we're gonna create our own actors, we're gonna give them as many disadvantages as possible. So this guy's gonna be a couch potato and have less athletic skill, and he's gonna have a lower chance to perform well on stunts, and he's unpopular, and he's a slow learner. Not to mention that athleticism is down in the tubes at an actual solid zero. And we'll be a little bit gracious. We'll take his charisma and make it a solid two, just to mix it up a little. And of course, they're not going to be 20. They're going to be 60. There you are, my silver fox.
No.
And while we're at it, let's change that name. You're no longer whatever that said before. Now your name is first name Reddy, last name to suck. And they said the perfect actor doesn't exist.
Oh,
look
poor
at that,
guy.
Looking great. Why would we go with boring old popular Heath at $14,000 when we can go with Ready to Suck, age 60, $997? That's over 14 times cheaper. What a savings. And while I was in the character creator, I might have made a couple more characters.
Oh,
after all, we have a lot of roles we need to fill. So I would like to introduce you to our new writer, actually illiterate, age 20. Another bargain deal. Not to mention our newest director, Forever Singleton, age 20. In fact, you may notice something of a trend. If they're an actor, I've made them 60. Every single one of them. If they're any other position at all of them are 20 years old. So we can touch upon both corners of incompetence. Ah, and I see a bus is arriving. Oh, good, and here comes everybody. Getting off the bus to come work. I'm not sure why the bus dropped you off at 1 in the morning, but who am I to judge, I guess. I'm kind of curious what happens now. At the moment, they appear to just be socializing and wandering around. Because I guess what else can you do at 2 in the morning? Okay, let's go ahead and speed up time and see if we can make this a little bit better. Oh good, it's starting to rain too. Nope, never mind. As quickly as it came, it's gone. The good news is someone's finally going to work. Or is off to take a crap. I guess we're gonna find out. Nope, never mind. Nope. False alarm. I did notice something suspect. I think the game has decided to hide some of my items. Like, I'm pretty sure that there used to be a toilet right here. See, there it is. I knew I wouldn't leave a gap like that. Not to mention, I'm pretty sure I put a kitchen right here. Yeah, like that one. Literally that one. And if I try to come back here and place another kitchen, it says objects are intersecting. I assume because the ghost kitchen is actually still there. But if we take this and move it over to the side of it, well, that works just fine. Same deal with the toilets. I can no longer place one right here. That's fine.
Broken
we'll just place a wall
game.
Right there. You made me do this. Also, it looks like our people are having food needs, up to and including a bunch of people that were just using the bathroom, I guess. You know, the person to blame is this guy right here. He could do his part and actually do some cooking, or he could just wander around and socialize. I thought maybe
I had some control over what they do,
but when you click on him, it just brings up this menu, and then I see him doing nothing but wandering around and complaining some more. Come on, sir, it's up to you to... Or you could just fall over. Oh, and you're back up again. Maybe you should have been an actor. Well, I guess they're just gonna stand around in the nighttime and complain about needing to sleep and how hungry they are. And occasionally, they all teleport into the stalls to take dumps simultaneously. Okay, so they've been milling around for a while, not doing anything to help themselves. We've got this maintenance worker that's perpetually stuck between these two toilet hallways. We've also got this other 20-year-old stuck at the end of the hall. You know what it is? They probably just need something to do. So let's get ready to make our next big project. And that's putting down a movie set. We're gonna go with the super basic default
one
for now.
They just need something
to
do.
Ah, yes, perfect. Only the best weird, awkward medieval set for us. With the most amazing up-to-date equipment. And to go with that, it's time to enter product creation. Here's where we get to customize the kind of movie we're making. And yeah, you can randomize and get all kinds of things that sound like actual movie titles. But we'll come up with something more appropriate. But first, let's choose our product type.
You again?
For now, it's just gonna be a movie.
Never gonna keep
which
me
it's
down.
Gonna be a low-budget one, because that's all
I
we're trusted
up again.
With for now.
Your
for
name
genre,
gonna
we're
keep
going
me
with
down.
Romance.
That's right.
And for theme, we're going with vampire. And I guess because we haven't researched it yet, we can only do G-rated movies. Ah, yes, a low-budget vampire romance movie for all audiences.
Bro, that sounds great.
Starring only geriatrics. That won't be awkward at all. And to go along with that G-rating, we're gonna have no lore, no dialogue, no story, atmosphere, or conflict, or suspense, but all the gore in the world, and tons of hardcore intimacy. And now for the name of our movie. Violent Geriatrics Hugging and Kissing. Oh, I can't fit any more letters. Well, just for consistency, then, we better take off this G, too. Yes, there we go. Violent Geriatrics Hugging and Kissing. Fun for all ages. And now on
Bro.
To scenes and sets, we get to choose a bunch
Hi,
of filming
Ken.
Locations.
Hello,
choose
How
set,
are you doing?
Our glorious default set, followed by our next amazing set, the default set again, and then to round out this masterpiece, the default set. And just to spice it up, how many extra scenes can
this
we
is
add?
Movie?
Oh, wow, we can add quite a few, can't we? Wait, is there actually a limit to how many scenes we can do in this? Oh, that sounds getting kind of crunchy. But let's not let that stop us. Oh, the game froze. Well, that'll teach me. Okay, wait, I think I found the problem. It turns out when you add too many scenes, the game wants to have a little more RAM. And by a little, I mean a lot. And by a lot, I mean nearly all of it. Game, I appreciate your efforts to try to get upwards of 55 gigs of RAM. But look, we don't have to do it this way. I'll just add less scenes. Let's just go with a mere 50 instead. Which, of course, now I have to go to each and every one of these and choose the right set. And done. Oh, and if we're gonna do that, we have to add some extra stunt scenes. I guess I didn't learn my lesson the first time, did I? And each one of them has a negative modifier, it looks like. Because for one, we don't have a stunt person. And on top of that, our actors are basically incapable of everything. But hey, how can you go wrong with 30 stunts in one movie? All that for $50,000. And I was gonna move on to post-production, but I can't actually click on that yet. I guess we just release it immediately after filming. Works for me. Create product. And the movie process begins. As you can see, the screenplay is already underway. Ah, and our first roadblock. We need to have violent geriatrics hugging and kissing ready by the end of the week. There's no
at the end of the week.
With, a voice responded from the crowd. I can't do it, actually says. And don't forget, this is the person we hired to do our writing. First name, actually. Last name, illiterate. And we have three choices. We can go with this nice approach. You need to take a break. It's all right. We'll get back to it tomorrow. Except we're not going to.
Ugly.
Nor are we going to do take your time and deliver a good result.
My God.
We're going to go with
You're
the
high good.
Pressure answer.
I'm also
Everyone
good.
Is waiting for
we're,
you out there.
We're doing
get
a waiting room for my
give
future
us a
VTuber
that
brother.
We can work with. I know you're only 20.
He's debuting
in
about 20
care.
Minutes.
See, there we go. That's
so
all it took.
Once this video is over, we're probably
going to
wrap
up.
And
rate
him,
because
he'll probably be live by then.
I'm sure she's fine. Also, how did you even get in here? Ah, and here we go. Filming is about to begin.
Yo, the vampires.
Just get in there
cool.
and do your 50-plus scenes of hugging and kissing. And no, I don't care if all of you are hungry and tired. So they've been standing here all day and all night doing no filming. What's the problem? Oh, wait. There's like a thing up here. Waiting for crew. Oh, whoops. My fault. Well, our actors are here, as is the director. Well, where the heck is our crew guy? Oh, silly me. I forgot to hire one. No problem. I made this guy to be our crew person. Behold, accident prone. Ah, another midnight delivery, I see. Where our guy gets dropped off on set in the cover of darkness. Finally, we can get this show on the road at 1 in the morning. I'm sure this feels optimal for everybody. And now for the riveting filming of everybody standing around, gesturing wildly with their arms, while the director sits and does
Perfect.
Nothing. This guy figures out how to use a camera for the first time. But whatever, this film is getting made at a breakneck pace. And you can
Whoa.
Tell this camera guy is fitting in because he just had his moment where Whoa. He had the vapors. And apparently, that's how movies are made. And done. Congratulations, actors. This calls for swimming in the floor. Oh my
Yippee.
Goodness, the film has come out, and we've achieved a beautiful 28. And so many memorable quotes. An insult to the film industry.
Oh.
A mockery of an attempt. It makes you wonder if they did it on purpose. Oh, reviewers, you can see right through me. And then if we look over here at ticket sales, we sold 3,828 tickets.
Not
bad. Oh my God, we can actually watch the movie. Oh, well, look at that. It starts with the title screen and the credits and everything. Ah, yes. Look at this cinematic masterpiece. One camera angle played over and over again of three actors wildly gesticulating, of which one of them we can't even see their face. And then about halfway through, something changes. Oh, I guess this must be all the stunts we did. I'm glad it's the same one stunt over and over and over again. Honestly, I can kind of understand how about 3,000
people would tolerate this. Oh, this fuck camera, yeah, the most jankiest.
It has just the right amount of art factor. You may also notice that our expenses tally up to $67,800. We didn't lose all that money, though. Due to our stellar ticket sales, we only lost $6,500. But I bet we can make up that difference after we head on over here to the research button and go all in on technology. We can go from our crappy 1900s camera all the way up to something a little more today. Oh, geez, this thing takes 3,040,000 research points. But never fear, we appear to have 8,295,000
okay.
research points. How or why? Don't know, don't care. All I know is we're buying this camera. And to go along with this, we'll go with the nicest 2010 lighting. Yes, good, great. And I would go with this really expensive microphone, but we don't have enough RP for it. We're just not gonna have a microphone at all, because now I realize we could spend that money on something else, like fire effects.
Oh my
yes,
God.
Please. This is also the place we unlock a bunch of other things we probably care about, like being able to produce a TV show, not to mention being able to do bigger and bigger budgets. So we're just going to unlock all of these. Ooh, and we can also unlock different ratings and genres. Well, just so we have them, we'll unlock all the ratings. You never really know when you're going to be inspired to make an NC-17 movie. And we'll also unlock all the genres so we have plenty of choices moving forward. Oh, geriatric movie update. For whatever reason, I didn't realize we'd have a second month of sales. Now we've made money off this monstrosity. A whole $10,000. Well, now I'm curious how long this will go. If we just let the months pass by, which by the way, I don't know what this anything even means. Oh, it's scheduling. Is that why no one's eating? Like if I just select eat and tell them right now is the time to do that. Oh, there he goes. Expertly staring at the grill like it's his first time seeing it. Because let's be honest, it probably is. Uh-oh, actually illiterate is unable to reach a canteen table. Well, you're just gonna have to learn to share. We only have the one. What if I just tell you to work all 24 hours of the day? Well, it turns out switching everyone to do work only appears to be no different than leaving it on anything. I mean, that's fine. We'll just leave it on work all the time then. And month number three, we made another 4.9 thousand for a total profit of 15. And month number four has shown even more profits. I'm not gonna say no to that extra cash. Oh no, what's this? Illegal poaching? Ready to suck walks in with an envelope in hand. The logo of
Artsy
Pictures is visible in the upper left corner.
No
they made
way.
Me an offer after watching me
I
in violent
do,
geriatrics.
After hearing please, please, please. By Sabrina Carpenter became obsessed with her music, binge listened to her entire discography all the way back to 2016 stuff. I guess when I like an artist, I don't like one. Damn, dude.
I'll stick around with my current salary. Yeah, that'll teach you. Never try that again. In fact, where are you? There you are. Merging with the director, I see. Well, hold still. I want to talk to you. Ready to suck? Get ready to be fired. And now that we've done that, let's go back over to hire employees and let's hire him back. Well, well, look who's come calling back. I hope we learned our lesson this time. Oh, and check this out. This year's Filmwood Awards ceremony is about to begin. Oh my god, I'm so excited. Any award could go to us. Except Best Director, because we weren't nominated. Or Best Producer, where we also weren't nominated. Or Best TV Actress, where there was only one nomination at all. Oh. I'm so confused. Oh, finally we're nominated for something. Best Looking Studio. And we won. For well-maintained lots, tasteful decorations, and tidiness
everywhere. It was definitely the Christmas wallpaper, wasn't it?
And I must say, I'm not surprised given how amazing our studio looks. Well, for our win, we apparently get 1,000 studio the Christmas fans. And plus one employee happiness. Wow, look at them now. Their happiness is off the charts. Well, now I feel extra motivated to begin our next big classic. Let's get started.
Oh,
and we're
going to
play it kind of safe this time. With another romance. Except this one's going to be an alien romance.
Let's go. Xenomorph romance?
Rated R. And let's see, this time let's go all lore. No dialogue. No story, no atmosphere, all conflict, no suspense, no gore, and no intimacy. I think we've created the most boring looking movie of all time. Alien geriatrics.
What's
crying
with his geriatrics?
Over books. And this time we're gonna go with the three scenes, which are still decorated for a vampire theme. And what the heck, let's add a stunt scene. Wait a minute, what does it mean to direct the scene? It's exactly what you think it would be. We get to direct this stunt. Okay, well let's see, instead of doing that jump, I think this alien love story calls for CPR, and we can't forget to add our practical effects. So let's see, what does fire do? Well, I don't really know what I was expecting. What about you guys? Can I, like, move you around? Oh, good, you really can. And you can rotate them into the fire. Now we're talking. And now if this wasn't good enough, now we can adjust the camera movement. So instead of a static, let's focus on our actors. Zoom in as far in as we can. Camera shake all the way to the most. And let's take that shake speed up as high as it'll let us go.
Oh boy,
we're all gonna be sick. Well, if we're gonna finesse that stunt scene, we might as well direct the other scenes, too. So for scene number one, we're just gonna have one actor who we're gonna take and have them face the camera. Yeah, just like that. And then instead of standing and talking, we're gonna have them act out getting stabbed. Yeah, you're doing great. You absolutely look like you're getting stabbed. And then for camera movement, we're gonna kind of aim it down like this. And we're gonna zoom all the way in. Oh. Yeah, there we go. Perfect. That's the opening shot of our movie. Then moving on to scene number two, which is gonna feature Late Life McCrisis and Madam Has-Been, where we're gonna have Madam Has-Been doing the animation of kissing slow. Now get ready for your big scene of making out with this wall back here. Yes, there we go. The scene is complete. And finally, we'll cap this off with scene three. We're gonna select gangster shooting for all three. So they're all irresponsibly firing guns on set, horrifically close to each other's faces. Okay, it's time to create that product. I don't know, say what you will, but I think this is gonna turn out to be a masterpiece. We can already see how this awkward scene is going.
And this dude's YouTube content is 10 out of 10. It's pretty funny.
Yeah, an even lower score than before.
What? And he works so hard on this.
We have to see this masterpiece for ourselves. All right, hit us with the good stuff. What do you mean they didn't like this? I mean, didn't you see the gun scene? And how could you not love this stunt? What a cinematic masterpiece. And unfortunately, our ticket sales weren't as good. So we lost some money and we got to turn this around. But in order to ensure that, we're going to go with the safe sequel. To geriatric, to kissing. But this time we're going to build a new set in the set designer. We're going to go with this Western theme.
Because it has
a balcony.
The way he narrates his shit sounds me. It's
so because it totally
funny.
Makes sense, we'll put a bank vault right there, and maybe some of these fancy candelabras and some nice rugs to tie it all together.
Nice.
Oh god, it's so
big.
Hi, Prim. I don't know if
how
this
are
is
you
fit
today?
On our lot. Well, thank goodness we can expand for cheap. Okay, perfect. There
doing?
We go. And that's where we're gonna film all of our scenes. Which, by the way, my disappointment has no boundaries. What's the point of having this balcony if I can't use it? Well, whatever then. Front and center you go. I'm pretty sure none of this matters anyway. And now it's time to create that. Uh-oh. Not enough money. Oh, I don't even have 50 grand, huh? Oh wow, that set was expensive. expensive. Now we only have $229. Uh-oh. That's okay. That's what the bank is for. Specifically for giving us a loan. Oh boy, and me with a credit limit of $1 million. Don't mind if
you're
I
good?
Do.
I'm
and
also good. I'm also
cash.
Good.
And now
10 more minutes
created.
Till debut.
Oh boy,
let's
I can't
go.
Wait
let's
for this
go.
Cinematic masterpiece. Oh, and something else I noticed. I figured out where you can reshoot the scenes. So if I'm not happy with that 20% rating, I can just tell it to reshoot. Yeah, get up there. I expect you to do better this time. Okay, so I reshot them over
yeah,
and over and over
it's
again.
8:48.
And I'm pretty sure this is the best it's gonna get. It's now April 2013, and we've burned through almost all of our money. But I'm proud to say that 2G2K is finally releasing. Now all that's left
2G2K.
For us to do is wait for the reviews to fly in. Oh boy, fingers crossed. Zero? Really? What were all the reshoots for then? I did get 100% in scene retakes. That's gotta count for something.
What the
but it
heck?
Did have decent ticket sales, I guess, at 85,000. Although we're still in the hole 101,000. Okay, new strategy. Clearly, reshoots are for suckers. So instead, we're gonna do one last ditch effort. I'm gonna hit
okay.
random a bunch of times. There, that's the movie we're going with. Slider's completely arbitrary. Only one actor to save money. Old harder. And now the absolute moment. That this is done filming whatever the hell this is. The moment that progress bar hits 100, that film is finished and sent out to release. And with only $5 left
oh
in our bank
God.
Account, this is our absolutely last chance to succeed. So let's hope we do okay. Yep, 26, tasteless and simply wrong. That's not the part I care about, though. The part I care about is those day one sales.
Whoa.
And wouldn't you know, 14,970 tickets
so
sold.
What is all that
our
extra?
Our film is immediately profitable by
what is all that extra $177,000.
Oh, good. Look at that. We're cash positive again. Wait, so can I just do this every time? Like, if I just randomly assign everything, wrinkles to die for. Will this speed build work every time? And done. And release. And crappy reviews. And ticket sales are enough where we still manage to turn a profit. Okay,
what?
I think I now understand how this game works. So here's what we're gonna do next. First, let's go ahead and expand our studio space. So pretty much as far as the game is gonna allow. Okay, great. Now we have a lot more space to work with. Now we're gonna take this crappy thing, move it out of the way. And now let's head over to this back corner right here. Head on over to sets, grab the default one, and now it's time to build and build and so on and so forth.
Oh my
okay,
Jesus.
Now we've got 27 additional sets to work with. Who cares that they're literally all identical? You can see where this is going, right? Well, momentarily anyway. We still don't have very much money, so let's make another crappy cash grab real fast. Oh, who am I kidding? They're all crappy cash grabs. And paid. Okay, now we have $110,000, which means now we have enough money to do two low-budget films. Although one problem we're gonna have is we only have one director. And that director's gonna need a camera guy, too. No problem, it's hiring time. And I don't want to pay high prices for all these overachievers still. That's okay, import character to the rescue. We can just add a clone of our director. See, there he is. This is getting out of hand. Now there are two of them. And we're gonna do something kinda interesting
Jesus.
Here. We have Geriatric 6. And now for our next movie, we're just gonna do Geriatric 6 again. Although everything else will be totally random. This won't be confusing at all for audiences, right? Two
no.
movies with the same name coming out of the same studio. All of it by the
completely
same writer,
different.
But with completely different premises. Shot
yeah.
simultaneously. Both of which are released on the same night. Ah, and here come the first reviews. Oh, I like this review. It's like they were so flabbergasted they didn't even read the quote. And listen, if you didn't like this Geriatric 6, well then why not try this other Geriatric 6? What a score! Speaking of scores, I'm not gonna say no to these ticket sales. All I can tell you is we went from basically no money to 180,000, which means we can hire more cheap clones. Now we can make three variations of the same movie back to back. So far, every time we release an onslaught of these failures, we basically double our money. And we also had to go and clone some of our actors. Because now we have six of the same title in production.
Oh my
Jesus. At
this
point, I'm not even looking at the scores. I'm just closing these as fast as I can. I don't care when I made $500,000 all at once. Well, if six at once is good, then how about...
Oh my god, what is the point?
Okay, here we are, still making movies. It's now February 2033, 18 years later, and we went from $500,000 to $2.1 billion. You might notice on the side here that we're up to Geriatric 24, where our movies
Let
now make like $10 million
acting.
Each on their first day, and we hired a whole bunch of additional clones, giving us a total of 80 employees, which, by the way, is the limit to how many employees we can have. I have to admit, though, the entire process is kind of a pain. We gotta sell set all this stuff, and then we have to choose one of our director clones, and then the writer, and then we have to select one of our many Mrs. Failures, and it's not a lot of work to do once, but to do it over and over again, it's kind of labor intensive, and our first day ticket sales tend to be always around 10 million, and that's too predictable for me. Then I realized there's something over in research that might help us out, and that's the marketing office. Unlock the marketing menu where you can launch marketing campaigns to boost your products and stars. Sounds like it's worth a shot to me, and I created and hired a character named Crying Inside.
What in the world are you watching? This guy just plays.
The next step is we need to get a movie in production.
Random games and tries to break them.
And looking at the different campaigns we can do, we're gonna do billboard advertising because it has the widest range of +25% to 50%. And create campaign. And now while this movie is off being filmed, Crying Inside is off. Actually, he's just
crying inside
me. Everybody else. But it says he's doing stuff, so I guess there you go. Okay, here we go. The billboard advertising campaign concluded and added +100 hype. Well,
ooh,
I don't really know what that means, but I guess we'll see if that mattered when it releases, which is if we made more than 10 million in the first day. Oh, wow, that really made a difference. Okay, wait, can we have more than one marketing guy? Yes, actually, it turns out you can hire as many people as there are desks. So now there's 12 desks in here, which means now we have 12 marketing guys.
Jesus
and get another
Christ.
Movie in production. It's time for all 12 marketers to do their thing. I guess they do hang out in the office sometimes. Okay, and the campaign is complete, and now it's added 300 hype. No, wait, 525 hype. No, wait, 1,102
hype. Oh my
hype.
God, he's about to make...
I guess I'll just wait till the rest pour in and we'll see where it lands. Okay, it looks like the final number is 196,672. I wasn't really paying attention, but it just clicked in my brain that the hype gain is a percentage, which I guess means it builds on itself, or so we'll see. Oh, wow, that's a lot of ticket sales. 1,955,776,647 tickets sold. For how much in first day sales? Oh, a mere $43 billion.
A mere $43 billion.
Moving forward, and that's how we made over $100 billion. And lastly, let's head back to the bank. This time, it's for studio shares. Here's our cash on hand versus everybody else. Our $115 billion against everybody else's sad amounts. So I have an idea. Let's just buy out everybody. Owning shares of another studio lets you receive part of its monthly profit, proportional to the amount of your shares. Oh, so you mean all of it across the board? Well, I guess we are the filmmaking business now, owning every single studio that exists. So I hope you had fun. I know I did. And I'm sure Mrs. Failure, now age 92, also did. And I'll see you next time.
What the fuck, bro? Oh my god. That was funny. That was funny. I enjoyed that. Oh, man. Oh, man. That was too good. That was too good. Holy shit. Like a G6. Oh my god. Okay, let's go to...
When I throw it back, is it fast enough? If I speed it up, and you handle that, you ain't
ready
for this work. Now watch me.
No! Maybe that has to be a channel point redeem, because then I can make the clip as long as I need to. The fucking clap, I know. Not today, Prim, because this morning stream is literally just so we can raid Zindi, because he's debuting. But I'm streaming at my usual time at 2. But who are you gonna recommend? Maybe I can follow them still? Like a G6. A G6. I love Technoblade's Potato War. What the heck is that? Gray still plays. Maybe we could raid him another time. Whoa. Maybe I can set it to 20 seconds in the menu. That is the max for bits at least. Okay. Maybe that'll work. Gray still plays. Wait, on Twitch? I don't see anyone. The G6. Sounds good, waifu. Oh, he's on YouTube. Oh, I thought you meant to raid. I'm confused. I'm so sorry. I'm sorry. My bad. Gray. There he is. Okay. I'm stupid. Bubby, bubby. Whoa, time to wake up. I'm awake. It's okay. Bum, 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 bum. Let's stay over here. Zin. He's live! Oh my gosh, look at the starting screen. Let's go. Okay. Let's go. Get in there, gamers. Get in there, gamers. Yo, look at the emotes. Not the grab, eh, yo? It sits. I'm so excited. Okay. They like to break games as well. Let's go. Okay, everybody get your raid messages ready. Grab your raid messages. You like to call Zindi small? Zindi is small. We love Zindi. 15 minutes, Zindi! You gonna make us wait 15 minutes? Ah! I'm gonna make you guys wait 15 minutes, so I guess that's fair. 15 minutes! OMG! Actually, that gives me time to go get my breakfast. So we gonna do that. We gonna do that. Okay, gamers. I'll be back at 2 p.m. Oh. Yeah, I'll be back at 2 p.m. Go with Zindi. A happy debut. Waiting in the waiting room for the waiting. Waiting. Gives me time to go get some food. So that's good. That's good. Yes. I'm excited to see. Hold on, no, the way it's frozen. I hate this. The way it's frozen! Grr. Okay, have fun, everybody. Have fun seeing my brother's new model. And I'll see you all later, 2 p.m. BST, in 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 5 hours. 5 hours. And we'll be doing more Elden Ring. And hopefully killing the fire giant. And then, I don't know, after that. Into the snowfields and shit. I don't know. I love you. Thank you for joining me this morning. I'll see you very soon. Thank you, Zanzu, for the gifted subs again. Thank you. Thank you for the follows. Thank you. I love you. I'll see you soon. Mwah, 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 mwah. Bye. I love you. Have fun with Cindy. Bye.